Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. My name is Maria and I'm a part-time reseller on eBay and Poshmark mostly, but I also do a little bit of Kitizen and Depop. And I am here with three giant bags full of stuff from the Delaware bins. So if you happen to not be aware, the bins are the Goodwill Outlet Clearance Center where they throw everything in these big blue bins and you dig through everything and pay it by the pound. So if you want to watch a video, I will link it up above here where I found all of these items. I did a thrift with me where you can see me try to find some gems amidst what is sometimes the garbage of the bins. But it's a lot of fun, so take a look at that video if you missed it. However, I was able to walk away with an IKEA bag full of clothes, a smaller bag full of shoes, and then some random household items. And as we go through, I'll try to tell you guys my kind of reasoning for picking up this item, as well as what I hope to resell it for. All right, I'm gonna start with the shoes and things, but the first one is a little bit interesting. This is a Ravensburger puzzle, 1,500 piece puzzle. So I've been having a little bit of fun recently where every time I go to the bins, I usually pick up a book, but now I'm also picking up a puzzle if I find a nice one. And what I will do is I will put the puzzle together, me and my family, and see if it is complete. And then if it's complete, I'll photograph it and list it on eBay. However, I have not yet found a complete puzzle at the bins that I put together. So we're gonna try this one out. I've done two other Ravensburger puzzles by now and neither of those were complete. My parents are coming into town in a couple weeks to do my kid's bathroom with me. We're remodeling that bathroom, so my dad and I are hopping on that project. But in the evenings, my mom and I will probably put together this puzzle. So follow me over on Instagram. It's at Life with MariaNicole. If you're not already, I will probably post kind of check-ins about this puzzle to see if I finally get a complete one to sell over on eBay. Okay, the next thing I got is the most adorable Barbiecore purse. If you are not following, the Barbie movie just came out. Barbiecore has become such a thing, and I found this like see-through acrylic little chain bag, and I'm hoping this will just sell maybe over on Depop or eBay. I have no idea what for. I have not looked up what something like this will sell for. I just thought it was cute. I bought it completely on style only. I have no idea what this is. I think it is unbranded. So obviously I don't think that will go for a ton, but it was too cute right now with the Barbie phenomenon that was going on. So I couldn't leave it there in the bin. All right, the rest of the bag is full of the shoes that I was able to find matches for. If you did watch my Thrift With Me video, I found so many good shoes that I could not find matches for and I had to leave them behind. So RIP all the single shoes that I didn't find at the bins, but we all know that is often how it goes. But I did actually find some decent pairs of matches, so I was happy about that. The first, which I have not sold before, is a pair of Lulus, really nice classic shoes. I have not sold Lulu's shoes. I've sold Lulu's dresses. I'm gonna just try out the shoes, see what I think. But these are kind of the lace-up style where they lace all the way up, so hopefully I'll be able to find a stock picture for these. These are size 8.5, just a nice stiletto classic black shoe. This was one of the single pairs that somehow, like in a bin on the opposite side of the store, I was able to find the match. So you never know, hold on to them and see. But they're just a pair of little Merrell Kids youth sneakers. I usually list these between like 30 and 35, hoping to sell around 25. These are a size 12. I actually at first was hoping to keep them for my daughter, but they're just a skosh too small. All right, these were the first pair I found. They're just a pair of Skechers slip-ons, kind of a classic bread and butter brand. They're the air-cooled memory foam in a size 8. Those will probably, you know, 20 bucks or so on those. All right, these were actually a decent find. These are Adidas Copa soccer football. I haven't looked them up yet other than to look up comps really quickly in the store, and I did see they were selling consistently over on eBay for 40 to 50 or so, and I don't remember what they were at that time. But these are a men's size 9. Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, these might have had comps that were better than that, so I'm not sure. I haven't typed everything in my inventory, so I'm not positive. I'm just going off what I can remember or what I usually sell shoes for, but I've never sold a pair of shoes like this. Okay, these were an exciting find. I was surprised to still find these in the bin because the bin had been picked through, but these are a like thigh-high Steve Madden stiletto, and they are in great condition. So yeah, you can kind of see that in there, but you'll just have to trust me that these are Steve Madden, and they're really, really, really nice. I'm trying to remember what the size is or where I found the size, but yeah, I'm trying to remember if these fit me or not, because if they do fit me, I'm certainly going to have to wear them first because they are definitely a moment. All right, another super high over the knee boot. I love these. These do fit me, so I probably will try to wear these potentially. But all the way lace up, zipped, like a block heel boot. Going into fall, I think these will do really, really well. There's another pair of these that were kind of like it that I ended up leaving behind. These are Carlos Santana. So I think what I was thinking was if I look these up and they will sell decently, because they are real suede leather, that I will sell them. And if for some reason the comps aren't great, that I will just keep them. But I think the comps are going to be decent. I would venture to guess that I will get over 50 for these because they are genuine leather. They're super cute. We're going into the right season. But I'll, you know, have to look them up and see. And lastly, these were the shoe find of the day and was a first for me. I have never found this brand before, but I was just walking by a bin. The shoes were kind of like haphazardly sometimes thrown in with the hard goods. And I just saw them sitting there. Fly London. So I saw the little bee like sticking out, just laying there, and I knew immediately what that was and figured there was something wrong with them because they looked almost like they had been thrown back. So I looked them over and they're in fantastic condition. Oh, I dropped one. So these are just a pair of a black suede leather booties. And again, going into fall, this is the perfect season to be listing them. This is a size 38, and yay for my first time finding Fly London. All right, that is all of the shoes. I do have this really random bag of like hard goods I grabbed for my family, so I'm gonna run through those super quick. So one, I just like to have little baby presents kind of on hand at home for baby showers and whatnot. So this is just a little Mickey Mouse Disney baby cups. This is one of those like silicone baking mats that I have always meant to buy. It needs a extremely good wash and bleach and like everything. And if it doesn't come all the way clean, I'll just toss it. But I think it will because I like making cookies. So hopefully this will be good for that. All right, I did pick up one more puzzle. This is a little sealed unicorn puzzle that I'm probably gonna put in my doctor's stocking for Christmas. And I also found little just foam baseballs that'll probably go in my son's stocking for Christmas. He loves balls right now. And then in this bag, I found this and then I ended up using it, was just some little Halloween decor that I pick up to have on home. So 31 October with the spider and then some super cute little pumpkins. Ooh, this one, oh, they're stuck together. This one is like glittery and that I can use all fall. It's not super just Halloween. And then two little ceramic jack-o'-lanterns. So I thought those were super cute. All right, now let's get into clothes. Clothes was a struggle for me. If you watch my thrift with me, this bin's location just has its own culture where apparently they don't even sort through their bag donations. They just throw them in the bin. So when they get you behind this red line and they say go and everybody goes, you're not allowed to run. They yell at you, but everyone runs. You go try to grab a bag and then like put it back in your car. And then there is loose items that you're digging through also. And then everyone usually goes back if they were able to get a bag, dig through it and see if they got anything good. I did get a few bags, but I think there was only one or two things in the bags that I even ended up keeping. But yeah, the first hour or so was really disappointing. I wasn't finding much, But then on the next couple of rotations, because I wasn't there for the store opening. I was like 5 minutes late. But once I did some rotations, I was able to find some things. So the first thing is just this little youth North Face jacket. I know people say North Face is saturated, but it still sells well for me. So if I can get it at Bins pricing and it's in good condition, I will still pick it up. So this is fleece on the outside, and this is actually a reversible jacket. So it has the soft shell on the other side, which is pretty cool. So the logo is on both sides there. This one does definitely, it's got some kind of dirt here on the bottoms, but I'm hoping that will come out when it gets washed. And if it doesn't, I'll just list it and say it would be my recommendation that you just don't use that, you know, reversible side is what I would do. Okay, keeping right on trend here is this North Face hoodie. And I don't remember, this is a medium. So I don't know if that's men's, women's, or unisex, but just really super basic. So basic one like that, I'll probably only list for 30 or so. All right, I found two really stunning girls' coats. This is by the brand Rothschild, which is a really kind of expensive designer, kids, like bougie brand. And they're especially kind of known, I think, for their outerwear. But this is a 4T, really soft pink. I would have loved to put my daughter in this, but she is almost 7, so that will not work. I loved how beautiful and kind of classic. It's just a timeless style, I think. And then I also found this little red number. I actually saw another reseller put this back and tell her friend that it's one of their older tags, so she put it back. And then you know what? I grabbed it because I think that a little girl is just gonna look so adorable in this. It looks really almost like Parisian to me with this like back flap. I think of Madeline. Is anyone familiar with those books? I can just imagine Madeline wearing this, you know, in her old house in Paris that was covered in vines. But yeah, I don't know. So honestly, I think both of those could sell between $30 and $40. All right, this one is in its own bag because this was in someone else's bag of donated clothes that I had to rip to even get open. And it's smelled like everything got put in there wet. So I only kept one item that I thought was worth saving, and then I found a new bag to put it in so I didn't contaminate all of my other items. And it just smells like kind of like a wet dog. So it's gonna get washed and it should be fine, and if it's not, I will just send it to textile recycling. But I wanted to at least try. So hopefully it doesn't smell too bad. It's not like awful. I just didn't want kind of the musty smell to get on everything else. But this is a really nice, I think it's vintage, L.L. Bean, like windbreaker jacket. And it's a men's extra large tall. No, just a men's extra large, which is a great size, great color. And other than, you know, it really is not terrible, but it's just kind of musty, like it's been in somebody's closet too long. I think it's in great condition, and I think it could also sell for $30 or so. Somebody wanted to say hi. Her little brother is sleeping and her movie just ended, so she was just coming up to say hi. Okay. Speaking of my little princess, these are for her. They are a pair of size 7, just Oshkosh little shorts. I always get my kids' clothes at Bins, and then once they wear them, I give them to either Once Upon a Child to make a little money, and then I use that money to go garage sailing. So it's like this cycle of life where I get it from the Bins, my kids wear it, I make a little profit, and then I use that profit to make more profit. So. Okay, here is a pair of Madewell jeans. I don't know if I've ever found Madewell blue jeans in the Bins. These are the High Rise Slim Boy Jean in a size 30. I was happy that these were not a skinny. I find Madewell skinny more often than not, and they kind of just sit for me. So hopefully these will do a little better and I can get maybe $30 from those. These were a super interesting find. These are the brand Helly Hansen, which is like an outdoorsy athletic kind of training brand. That's the logo, the HH logo right there, if you're not familiar, but it's pretty expensive. It's kind of similar to like North Face, but this is HH Workwear, which is a tag I wasn't familiar with, and this is new with tags. And these are rain pants, and I know that because there's a little umbrella with it raining, and they're just like really slick. So I'm assuming you put these over your pants as like work pants. And when I looked these up, again, I think, especially them being new with tags, these might bring me like $30 to $50 that they retailed closer to $100. So they are really like rubbery on the outside, but I guess that makes sense if they're supposed to be for the rain. All right, this was actually like one of the first things I found, and when I was finding like nothing this whole hour, I was excited to find at least anything redeemable. So this is just an Urban Outfitters size small, just little like loose fit, boxy cropped cardigan. Again, I am starting to shop for fall. It is almost sweater weather, and I love sweaters myself, so as a size small, I will wear this once or twice and then sell it. I like the chunky oversized buttons. I don't know, I'll probably get 20 to 25 on that. A few more things. I told you I like to find new baby items that I can give away as baby presents, and I found three super cute new with tags items. This is a little Primark sweater. It's got all this like school stuff all over it and little balls. I found a Carter's adorable little outfit here. It's got elephants on it, new with tags. And then the most fun one, still with the hanger and the Marshalls tag on it also, is this Disney baby little Mickey Mouse outfit. So obviously my 1.5-year-old is too big for all of these, but these will be super cute for somebody else in my life, the next boys baby shower I go to. All right, another pair of jeans. Again, I found these close to the beginning when I was looking for anything redeemable. These are a pair of BP 26 busted knee light wash pants. I actually sold like potentially the exact same jeans very recently for, I want to say like $25, actually over on Depop within just a day or two of listing. So I'm hoping that means they're a good style and that someone will scoop these right up just as fast as the last ones. All right, a couple things I think that are going to be for me. These are just, I wouldn't have bought these if they weren't for me. These are just a little Adidas workout tanks or just slouchy tanks that I can wear running errands or around the house. A black and a white. The black one is actually tied up with a little knot, which I think was aftermarket knot that somebody did. But if it stays like that when I wash it, I'll probably keep it because I'll think it's cute. But yep, two for me. My daughter brought me my water, so, and she's sitting right here watching me because she hasn't seen all the things I got. She thinks it's fun. So if I make little faces down here, it's to her. All right, oh, these are adorable. Okay, I probably am gonna hang on to these for my daughter. These are little like slouchy Oshkosh overalls. They're almost like feel like linen. I don't know if they actually are, but they feel like linen. Yeah, these are a linen viscose blend. So they're a size 10, she's almost 7, but she is tall, so she'll probably be able to wear these like next year. So we'll hold on to those for her. And then again, Oshkosh overalls I do usually sell, especially vintage ones. These are not vintage, these are modern. But I'll either do the Once Upon a Child thing with these or maybe even sell them myself. Okay, this is a little Vineyard Vines shirt. I think it's girls. This is a size small, but it says 8-10. So I'm assuming that means girls small, 8-10, but also going into fall. That should be super cute. Since it's girls, I won't get as much, but maybe $15 to $20. Here's another thing for baby girl. This is just a little rainbow skirt. Oh my gosh, her eyes are lighting up. She loves rainbows right now. So that means it was a good find. This is actually Land's End. There was a cute little shirt that went with this, but it had a big stain on the back. So I left that. All right, this was a decent find. These are a pair of Levi's orange tab, which means it's vintage. So this tab right here can tell you all kinds of things based on the color, based on the size of the E, but the orange tab are ones to keep an eye out. Silver tab are ones to keep an eye out for. Those sell spectacularly. But yeah, we're gonna try these. So these are men's size something. I'm not sure. But you can tell by the little paper tag in here that they're definitely vintage. And hopefully we'll get over $50 for those. Okay, this trip to the bins was definitely one that resellers were all over. And this, I think, might have been one that other people just didn't know the tag or the label, because other people had gone through this bin. This is three dots. This is a really nice like boat neck cowl, lightweight sweater. So a great transition piece moving from summer into fall into winter. And this is a viscose blend, so it's super soft, but three dots is something to keep an eye out for. So we will see how this one sells, but hopefully I'll get between $30 and $40. Okay, a pair of Bread and Butter men's shorts. These are just Puma, but they have the nice elastic around the waist. These are like a golf short. They are a size 38. And we're moving out of golf season, but I still think they will sell. I don't usually list things like this for more than like $25, but they do usually sell, and I like picking up some staples at the bins at bins prices. Okay, there's these, which I think are just for me. Yes, because these are Old Navy. These are just a pair of green like tie-dye joggers. Love these. I'll wear these around the house like every day. Old Navy. And then there's another pair in there somewhere, we'll find it, that I think are Nike, that I haven't decided if I'm going to keep yet. I'll probably try them on and see. Okay, this is a nice men's quarter zip sweater. Again, it is almost sweater weather. I like the elbow patches. That seems to have just been a classic style that guys always like. This is Land's End, and it's a size extra, extra large, 50, 52, which is great. And I want to say this is a really nice fabric, which is the other thing that helped me decide to get it. Yes, this is 100% wool, so I won't always pick up Land's End, but it being a great size, it is in absolutely excellent condition, good style, and being wool, I think this will sell between 30 and 40. This was a super cute Zara piece. I didn't find too much Zara. This is an older tag, but I decided to pick it up anyway. This is a size large, but how cute is this with the like crochet detailing all over, all the way down the sleeves, and then it ties in back. Love that. So boho, beachy, coastal grandma, those are all keywords I will use for something like this. It is like loose knit, but has like a sheer chiffon for coverage. And I think the back is probably like a linen blend, but the tag was pulled out, as Zara often is, so that is okay. I think it will sell on its own. I will probably list this for 28 and hope to get between 20 and 25. All right, another pair of just cute shorts for my daughter, but look how blinged out these are in the back. They reminded me of Miss Me jeans. They are mud. They are not Miss Me jeans, but she'll be able to wear that for the rest of this year and then into next summer, most likely. I got a lot of things for my daughter this trip. I don't know if I got anything for my son, though. We'll see. Okay, these were just, I didn't find tons and tons of stuff this trip, so I decided to grab these. These are a pair of J. Crew like men's chinos. J. Crew does sell for me if I pick up the right things. They're a tapered style on the bottom and are a size 33 by 32, 100% cotton. Just thought they were a nice style for the office. Could also be a great style for golf. I have no idea what I'm going to list those at. I have not looked it up. Okay, these I think I picked up for my daughter also. They're a pair of Air Jordan little joggers, size 8 to 10. If she wants these and wants to keep them, I'll hold on to them. And if not, I can sell these. I've sold these little Air Jordan joggers a few times for like $15 to $20. All right, this next thing is Lane Bryant, if you can see that tag there. This is the swing tee in a size 14, 16. I liked the gingham print. It's got like an elastic off the shoulder. I do like selling Lane Bryant, but only when I can get it at bins type prices. So this is something I probably list for like 24 to 26 and hope to get around 20. This I got right at the end, and someone was actually going through their, you know, bags they had gotten previously and were throwing things back. And I snagged it because I love selling this brand. That is Sigrid Olsen. I mostly sell her 100% linen stuff, which sells great for me. So this will actually be an experiment. Although I think this might be a linen blend. Let me look after I show it to you guys. I'm sorry. But it's a really, really pretty floral cardigan sweater. Love selling cardigan sweaters. Again, it's great for the season. I liked the color. I liked the pattern. It's got these really pretty buttons on the front. And it is a size 1X. I do find that the sizes in this brand sell better in the plus sizes. Okay, this is a silk rayon blend. So yeah, I don't know why this was thrown back. They might have just not been familiar with the brand, but it is in great, you know, excellent condition for sure. Not sure what I'm gonna list that at. I'm thinking probably around 35 maybe, since it is the silk blend. All right, this I think is just for me. I'm hoping that I bought it just for me. Yeah, this is Sonoma. So I definitely bought this just for me. But look how cute and snuggly. I actually remember trying this on in the bins, and it was so hot in there. So it was miserable to try on, but totally worth it. I love the like Aztec-y Southwestern print. It's a super soft like Sherpa. So yeah, this is definitely going to be mine for fall. My rule typically from bringing things home is, as you know, I like to wear something and then resell it. But if I find something like this that I have no intention to resell for, if I put it in my actual personal closet, I have to get something out of my personal closet. So I have one like this that's just like a white and black one that I'm going to retire. I don't remember what brand it is, so I don't know if I'll either resell it, donate it, pass it along to a friend, and then I'll replace it with that one because I think that one is so much cuter. All right, we are getting kind of close. We're over halfway through this bag. And let's see what we have. This is fun. This trip was like 2 weeks ago and the bags have been sitting. So I'm kind of remembering with you guys what I got. Okay, yeah, I think this was the only Talbots piece I got that day. And this is a Talbots size medium petite. I want to say this is linen. Definitely feels like it. 100% linen. I like the pleated details on it, especially like down the sleeves. And guys, you will not... I went to like three different windows trying to find the correct lighting to make sure that it was intentionally this like off-white color. I could not tell if it was just like the musty colored when it was supposed to be white. And I deduced that I even asked someone's opinion. And yes, we all agree that it is supposed to be this kind of beige color. It is a single color all over, so there's not like white spots and light spots. And it is a very beautiful color. I just wanted to make sure it is intentional. So since this is linen, I'll probably list between like 30 and 35 and hope to get around 30 for that. All right, this one I think I might be keeping. I'll probably look it up. I'm not sure. But this is a Calvin Klein like stretch dress, and yeah, I just thought it'd be cute in fall with like a pair of boots or like a pair of classic white like Keds or Pumas or sneakers. That would be cute, and it's in excellent condition. I don't know if this has ever been washed. This one was beautiful. I definitely like picking up Torrid, especially at Vince prices. This was a store pull, as you can see, it did not sell. And look how pretty this is. So going into sweater weather, I thought this would be really nice for like a holiday party with the bedazzling. And I did check it over really well to make sure all of the jewels are still there, and they are. This is also a size 3X, which is a great size in Torrid. So I'll probably list this around 30 and hope to get between 20 and 25. At the bins, I like to think that my target profit for an item, so after platform fees and after my cost of goods, is $20. However, I am more realistic that my target price is often between 10 and 15 when I'm paying these prices. So if I'm paying a full Goodwill price, I want to make sure I'm getting that $20 profit. I'm more willing to get a $10 or $15 profit at bins prices. Okay, I think this was the one other thing I got out of one of those bags, and it is a very nice L.L. Bean 100% traditional fit flannel, and it's thick enough that I'll probably also tag this as a shacket because you could wear it open as like a jacket with a shirt on under it, or you could wear it as a really thick shirt, so a shirt jacket. But yeah, I've had luck selling LL Bean stuff before, in this like button down style, and flannels are gonna start popping off hopefully here for fall. It does have some little like schmutz on it, but all of that looked to me like surface wear that will come out when I wash it. I usually list button downs from LL Bean at like 28, but since this is a really thick flannel, this one might be like 30 or 32. Okay, here are these joggers that I haven't decided. I'm gonna try them on and see what I think. I'll probably list them since I already got the green Old Navy joggers, but I don't know. These are Nike. I like this all the way down the side. I might keep these both only because I've been looking for more sweatpants to wear home from the gym, especially since we're gonna be moving into colder weather. So I won't really have to keep my one for one rule because I've gotten rid of some other ones without replacing them. So I actually need these in my life, and we shall see. I'm gonna put them in the selling pile. I don't know if they'll stay there or if they'll end up in the keep pile. Right, this was one of my favorite items. Not because of the money that I might make, but just because of how much I love it. This is like a topper poncho. And look how beautiful. This is so incredibly soft. And look at the coloring of this. Oh my gosh. If anyone watches McThriftsy, this is something I imagine her picking up and selling like instantaneously. So I hope that this sells as well for me. I don't think this has any tags. Oh, it does. It does have a tag. It says 100% acrylic. I have no idea where it was made, who made it, but that does not matter. I picked this up on Style. It's going to be the perfect season for it, and I think someone will absolutely love that. I will probably model that in my pictures just to get a better idea of what it looks like. Okay, we've only got a few more things here. Oh, I love this color. This is another little kid's North Face. And look at this like soft blue turquoise color. My daughter's sitting over here and I heard her whisper, "I want it." But it is a size 6, which means she's growing too big for it. So she might be able to wear it once or twice and then we can sell it. We'll see. But yeah, super adorable. Just needs a little bit of a wash and we'll get that listed. All right, I did pick up one pair of American Eagle jeans because it is the new label. I didn't have tons of inventory this day. Actually, and these are men's. These are 30, 32. Oh, I'm remembering this now. I actually picked these up for my husband if he wants them. And if he doesn't, I'm going to sell them. Although I'm seeing the problem. Hey guys. You think Daddy wants this? She said no. Never mind, guys. That would be problematic for someone to wear. So I can see now why they got donated. Here's a PSA, guys. If there's something wrong with your item, if there's a flaw in it, especially as a reseller, don't redonate it. There's enough clothes out there that aren't flawed. Because I know people are like, "Oh, someone could still stay warm in a jacket that has a rip down the side." Yeah, but there's other jackets that aren't ripped that they could stay warm in. So someone is just gonna fall in love with that item and take it home and then realize it has a rip in it, or another reseller is gonna find it. Send it to textile recycling. Don't just throw it away. Every second a garbage truck full of clothes ends up in a landfill. So you can Google it, you can find textile recycling near you, and they will sort it for you. You can find some that are charities that they will sort through all the items. So anything that is in good condition, they will sell for their charitable purposes to be sold in a thrift store. Anything that is not in good condition will get recycled into something else. So that's where these gonna end up. All right, this was a fun find. This is ALC Woman. ALC is a great brand to look out for. This is an older tag, so I don't think this is going to make me like, millions, but it is a size 3X. I think I should probably be able to get like $30 to $50 from this. I like the metallic stripes down it, and it's this really nice, like, deep wine color. I don't know what color it's coming off on camera, but it's a nice long line style. It's got split sides as like a tunic, and it buttons all the way down. Another one that's going to be great for fall and winter. All right, this is my last handful, guys. Oh, this is another one. This is going to be for me. This is just a really cute little sleep dress from Calvin Klein. It's a tank top, like racer back style. I like sleeping in things like this. Here's a Karl Lagerfeld. I completely know that this might have been something that was just sold at like TJ Maxx or on like Nordstrom Rack, something like that. But look how cute. I actually found two of these. I found one in a red color, but when I was sorting my cart, that one back here was like peeling. It was a little bit flawed, so I left that behind. But oh my gosh. I mean, is that a cat? Yeah, that's a cat. And it's like oh, my daughter's trying to get it. This is a size women's 3, so I will need to look that up, but that's probably like an extra large or so. Oh, this one I did get for my husband. This is just a nice soft flannel in a size medium. Denim and flower, Ricky Singh. I've seen this at like Marshall's and TJ Maxx. I think he has some from them, but that's for him for fall. He's also planning on replacing some of the flannels he has in his closet, so doing a swap. This is a Marmot sweater, which is a really nice like outdoors brand. I have only found it and sold it, I think, once, but it sold really well. So here's that if you're not familiar. It is a good outdoors brand to look out for, especially at bins pricing. This is a size medium. It's looking like men's medium, but anything with the nice like spell out logo from any brand is usually good, especially in hoodies. That brings me to my find of the day. I was done. I was just looking for my last shred of hope for those single shoes. I was over in the hard goods and I found this piece of white clothing just like peeking out, and I was like, let's see what that is, because it looked like it might be linen, which is why I grabbed it. So I pull it out, and yeah, it is linen. It is a beautiful pair of embroidered pull-on drawstring waist like trouser pants, like culottes. Look at this embroidery. And yes, this is Johnny Was. They're a size medium. They are 100% linen. They are in beautiful condition. There is not a thing wrong with them. I have looked them up and down, and I don't know why this was in that hard goods bin. I don't know if it was thrown back and someone just didn't know what they were, or picked them up that wasn't a reseller and thought they were cute and then, you know, threw them back. But this is my first time finding Johnny Was anywhere. So that was an amazing day for me, just the cherry on top of a fun trip, because I hadn't really found any other like super bangers. So yeah, this was a great way to end my day. I was tired, I was hungry, I had to go to the bathroom. Like, this made it all, you know, worth it. I think these retail between $300 and $350 from the research I was able to do. All right, friends, that is it for me today. I hope that you had a little bit of fun, that maybe you're being productive, doing some listings, taking some photographs, and just got to hang out with me, you know, this afternoon. It is Sunday for me, but whenever you are watching this, I hope you're just having a great time relaxing. I should have some more What Sold videos upcoming on my channel, so stay tuned for those. Click that subscribe button if you haven't already. You know, that's my shameless plug. It does absolutely help my channel. Give this video a big thumbs up if you had a little bit of fun or found it helpful, and I'll see you next time. Bye.